Where is your media? Where are your videos stored? Well, let me answer that for you. Today, it's all about libraries in Final Cut Pro X or 10. X, 10, in the new Final Cut Pro. Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld. Thanks for watching. And if you love this content, if you want to learn more, spread the love, hit that subscribe button down below, and let's learn some stuff. Today's topic is Final Cut libraries and understanding where your files actually live within Final Cut and where they're stored and why possibly it's filling up your hard drive space and you need 18 different hard drives because, let's face it, I'm pretty sure we've all been in those shoes before. So let's take a look and understand the concept of libraries and how Final Cut wants us to think about our organization. If I open up Final Cut, the very first thing is understanding libraries. And the best way to do that is to actually go to the Help menu. So I'm going to go up to the Help menu. I'm going to open up Final Cut Help. And if you've never used the Help menu before, it's actually really, really helpful. And not only in Final Cut, but also in regular Mac usage for your computer, iMovie, Photos, GarageBand, any application that's on your computer, the Apple menu for help is actually really, really helpful. Let's open this up and we're gonna open up this user guide and go to Table of Contents. And we're gonna choose what are libraries on the left-hand side. And this actually gives you a nice broad overview of what or how Apple describes libraries and how to use them within Final Cut. I don't think there's any right or wrong way to use them. It's just understanding how they work and what you can put inside of a library, what you can put inside of an event, projects, and understanding all of those different elements within Final Cut within this application. So if we look at this, the library itself is kind of the head honcho. It is the big bucket. It's the container that stores everything that you do inside of Final Cut. It could be clips, your raw video footage. It could be the projects that are used to tell a story using your raw video footage. It could be clips and projects. So there's multiple ways to use libraries, and this little diagram is helpful. So here they show the main library, and under there you can have an event. So naturally, events go into libraries. An event can contain either just all clips, all video clips, or an event could contain clips and projects, or an event could contain all projects. So think about what type of work you do, what kind of video you're working on, how you organize your footage. Maybe you have a lot of B-roll, maybe you have client work, maybe you're just home videos that you're storing in Final Cut. Like I said, there's no right or wrong way. It's just understanding how to find and organize your video footage and really where it's at on your computer so that if you do fill up your hard drive, you know how to move that content from one place to another, like an external hard drive or maybe a new computer. Let's go ahead and close this and let's look at our Final Cut libraries. Now over on the left-hand side, we have our sidebar for our libraries. If you don't see this whole section here, go ahead and click on the button to reveal your libraries. So if I toggle this on and off, I can show or hide this column. Also make sure that you have your browser turned on, because if you don't have your browser here turned on, you're not going to see anything over here on the left-hand side. Now, you all probably have noticed the very first time you actually opened up Final Cut, it created you an untitled library. And it's untitled just because it's wanting you to title it. I would title it as the first thing you do, because that way you know what it is, it makes sense, it's logical to your workflow. As you can see here, I have actually multiple libraries within Final Cut. So I have one called Untitled, I have one called Travel Vacations, my YouTube sound effects here, and I have another one, drone footage. So you can actually have multiple libraries open at the same time. And if I don't want one of these opened, let's say I don't need my sound effects and logos, if I right click on this, I could choose Close Library, or I could select the library here, go up to the File menu, and also choose Close Library. And that will just hide it from this list here. It's actually not deleting it, it's not removing it permanently. I'm just closing it because I don't need it. Now, if we look at the structure that I have, here's a couple examples. I have a Travel and Vacations Library, And this library contains different events. And the events are, let's say, the time of which I took that video footage. So here is North Shore. This was an event in my life. I traveled up the North Shore through Minnesota, and this is all the video footage within that event. So naturally, all of the clips here reside and live in this North Shore event. And that event lives in the library of travel and vacations. That way, when I go on another trip, I make a new event and start loading that content in that event. That way, I'm kind of filtering it and narrowing down the content that I have. If I go right below there, I have California 2020. So again, these are all of the video clips that I have from the California trip, and they're not mixed in with the North Shore, you know, doing all the hiking and everything like that. So all of that lives in this travel and vacations library. Let's pretend I wanted to create a new event in this library. So I can select the library here and go up to File, choose New, and then I can choose New Event. If I click on Event, let's say New York. So now event name, New York, I'm putting it within the library of travel because I don't want it in drones, I don't want it untitled, I don't want it in the YouTube channel. And I'm not gonna create a new project because I'm not working on a project. I'm just creating containers to hold my video footage. And if I click okay, I now have this New York event here ready for me to organize and put video footage in. Now, if we go back to that untitled one, I would recommend you to rename it. And it also creates you by default an event within there based off of the date that you created this untitled library. If you want to change the name of it, you just have to click it once after it's selected. And I could say, this is Family Videos. Press return, and then, you know, this event could be, let's say, birthdays. And I could create another event that could say File, do event. Maybe we do holidays. You know, you kind of get the idea of, you have this main kind of category, but then you're breaking it down into these subcategories called events. Now you'll also notice that inside each event, there is a folder called Smart Collections. And naturally, our instinct is to put files and pictures and such inside of folders, but it doesn't work that way here for whatever reason. I don't know. So a folder actually holds Smart Collections. And Smart Collections are just pre-created searches from Final Cut that automatically go and find video clips based off of ratings or people or whatever filter you apply to that. So if we look at these as an example, in the Smart Collections folder in the Travel and Vacations library, it's all of the same except I added one here for frame rate. So the way that you see what these filters are is if you go into the browser in this little magnifying glass, right underneath there you see the filter. If I click on this, I can choose and see that, okay, this is finding every video rate frame that is 29.97. So it's going through and finding all of that. If I click on projects here, it's gonna show me that the filter for this is the type is project. And I could change that to anything here. So that's something that will automatically go and find different clips based off of the filters and the criteria that you've set. Now, where are these libraries stored? Naturally, they're stored in the movies file of your home folder. So if I open up the Finder and I go to the movies, typically you'll find that untitled library here. For me, I have all of my library stored on my external hard drive. So if we look at this, they're designated, and you can see if I change it to the icon view, all of the libraries are these purple icons here. So these are all of the different libraries, and the beautiful thing about them is they're all self-contained. So right now, I have all of these libraries on my external hard drive, and if I wanted to take this external hard drive, plug it into a new Mac, as long as both Macs are running the same flavor, the same version of Final Cut Pro, I can pick up where I left off and start editing on someone else's computer. So it's really convenient to have all of your video footage within a library and specifically know where that library is at. Now, one of those things that you'll come across is space. You're gonna fill up space really, really quickly due to render files. Now, I'll explain that in a whole nother video, but I want to show you where and how that comes to be. If we take my YouTube channel, for example, I have a library called YouTube channel. This has all of my different projects that I have working on for the videos that I create here. Now, if I right-click on this, this is an easy way to find your library. If I right-click on it, I can say Reveal in Finder. If I go to here, notice it selected it. If I change it to List View, this library itself is 778 gigabytes. That's a lot of space. And I can tell you, the raw video footage that I have in there is nowhere near 778 gigabytes worth of space. And the reason it's so large is because the render files. Every time you bring a file down into your timeline, notice this little bar across the top of the timecode. This starts to render, and what that means is it's starting to process your video footage so that your computer can play it successfully 100% speed at the full quality of your video footage. Because sometimes, if you're depending on the speed of your computer and the specs that your hardware has, your computer has a hard time playing back video. If you've ever experienced drop frames or just the choppiness of it playing back, that's because your video needs to be rendered. It's like the cake needs to be baked in order for you to eat it. The video files have to be rendered out in order for you to play that video back in real time. Now, there's a preference for that. If I go to Preferences, Final Cut Preferences, under the playback, there's actually a background render, and it tells, if I check this box, it's going to start rendering that video footage for me automatically if there's no activity after the set duration I have here, and it's just gonna go through and start doing that. But my point is, as it does that, it's building up all of these other files that we could actually get rid of if we don't need them. If I go up to File, I can actually come down to Delete Generated Library Files. And this allows me to delete those files. So this is just a quick reference. I could choose OK, and it's going to delete all of those files. And actually, let's do it, because it's not going to delete any of my projects. It's not going to delete any of my raw video footage. So if I say Delete Unused Only, or I could say All, I'll say Unused. And that will be for all past projects that I've exported, things like that. It's going to go through and delete all of that, and then that should free up some space. Now, these libraries here, like I said before, they can be moved around. But the most important piece also, or one of the things that could cause you issues down the road, is when you first import your video footage, you want to make sure that you've told it to copy those files into the library instead of leaving them where they're at. So for example, I have a memory card here, and it's got some video footage on it. And if I put that memory card into my computer, if I go up to File, and I can do Import, and I can do Media, or I could use the Import button here in the top left. But here, I have my memory card selected on the left, but over here on the right, there's this option for files. Either copy to library or leave files in place. I highly recommend to copy the files into the library. That way, if you move the library from one location to another location, everything is self-contained inside that library. If you have it set to leave files in place, well, now it's just making a reference. Final Cut, when you open up Final Cut, it's going to be looking for wherever those files that were at when you imported them. So if we look at this, I'll import one clip here. We'll come up to the top. We'll do it into this event. We'll create a new event that just says test import. I'll tell it to leave the file in place. I'll do import selected. I'm gonna cancel out the rendering. And here it is. So the file is right here. Now, if I eject this memory card, and it's going to say, hey, can't do it. Okay, so let me click OK, because it's connected to Final Cut. Final Cut is using that media off that memory card. So if I quit out of Final Cut, go back and eject my memory card. Now, if I open up my library again, notice it says the file is missing. That's because it's looking for my memory card. It's saying, hey, wait a minute, you imported it, but told it to leave the file in place. So if I go ahead and plug back in my memory card, wait for it to mount, so wait for it to show up in my Finder, it will now relink it and it pops up again right here. So essentially, you want to make sure that I would highly recommend to always leave and import your videos into the library itself. Now, if you wanted to change that after the fact, let's say that I want to copy these files into the library, if I select this event and go up to File and choose Consolidate Event Media, it will actually do that for me. It will go through and say, hey, I'm going to copy all of the video footage. Do you want me, or the raw video footage, do you also want me to include the optimized and the proxy media? Well, for this, I don't have any, so I can just click OK. And I'll leave those checked. It's going to actually copy those into the event in that library behind the scenes. So if I click on, here's another shortcut or another trick. If I right click on this, on the clip itself and say reveal in Finder, this is another way where it shows you kind of behind the scenes where it opens up that library to show all of the organization that Final Cut has created for you. And again, don't go in here. You could potentially wreck some of your project files or your events, things like that. So this is just showing me that this video file lives in the original media, which lives in the event test import, which lives in this YouTube channel. So I can see that it now copied that file from the memory card and put it actually into the library without referencing it. So then I would be able to eject my memory card without Final Cut saying, hey, it's being referenced to that clip. So just notice, just another side note, don't go through here and mess around with any of this stuff, because this holds a lot of the functionality for Final Cut to work behind the scenes. So that is a little bit of Final Cut libraries, or the library is the bucket, the big organization that holds your raw video clips, your projects, your events, you know, all of the different ways to organize your media. And the libraries are very mobile. You can move them from one hard drive to another hard drive, and they can fill up pretty fast. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you liked it, show some love, hit that subscribe button down below, click that little bell, and we will see you next time with a brand new tutorial. Yes. So again, thanks for watching. If you have any comments, I'd love to hear what you have to say, and thank you so much for watching. Until next time.